Hello and welcome back to our YouTube channel Connecting with Numbers. This is a one-stop channel for all your mathematical queries. Our today's topic, which we are going to explain you all, is algebraic expressions. This topic is introduced to students from grade 7th and it is carried forward in other standards. Now, this topic is little confusing for students. So, here we are going to explain you in a very simplified manner. So, let's get started. Let us first see what are algebraic expressions. Okay? So, can you see these expressions? Now, these expressions are known as algebraic expressions. They always carry a variable and a coefficient with them. Now, what are variables? Here, can you see this expressions? So, in this expression, n is the variable. In this expression, t is the variable. In this expression, x and y are the variables. Okay? Now, let us see what are coefficient or constant. Now, in this expression, 3 is the coefficient of the variable n. In this expression, 3 is the coefficient or constant of variable t. In this expression, 2 is the coefficient of variable x, and 3 is the coefficient of variable y. Okay? Now, in algebraic expression, we are going to see what are terms. Okay? For that, let us consider an example. So, you can see in this expression, there are two terms. The first term is 15, which is a number. Whereas, the second term is minus x. Okay, so these are known as terms. Now, minus x is a term which contains coefficient. Since there is no number, so the number is always 1. So the coefficient of minus x is minus x and the variable x. Now, let us see one more example. In this example, there are 3 terms. The first term is 4x square. Second term is minus 2y. And the third term is 5 upon 6 xz. Now, the variable here is x. In this, the variable is y. And in this term, the variable is xz. The coefficient is 4. Here, the coefficient is minus 2. And here, the coefficient is 5 upon 6. Okay? So, very clear with the term concept? By now, we are very clear with what are terms. So, now we will move ahead with like and unlike terms. Okay? So, what are like terms? So, the terms which have variable same with same powers. So, the terms which have the variable same with same powers are known as like terms, whereas the terms where the variables are different with different powers. Okay, so like terms, here you can see this example. In this example, all the variables are same. Whereas in this term, the variables carry same powers, x square y, y x square. So, what are like terms? The terms in which the variables are same with same powers. Whereas when we come to unlike terms, what are unlike terms? Where the variables are different. As you can see in this example, the variables are xy, y square, xyz. So all the variables are different. Whereas you can see in this example, the powers are different. M square, n square, m cube n. So where the variables are different and the powers are different, they are unlike terms. Okay, I hope this concept of like and unlike terms is very clear with you all. Still, if you have any doubt or queries, you can ask us by putting up your question in the comment box. So, I think the basic concept of what are algebraic expressions, what are terms, is very clear to you all. Now, we will see the types of algebraic expressions. So, there are four types of algebraic expressions: monomials, binomials, trinomials, and polynomials. So, what are monomials? The expressions with one term are known as monomials. Expressions with two terms are known as binomials. Expressions with three terms are known as trinomials. And expressions with more than three terms are known as polynomials. Let us see an example of each. Now, as you can see, 4x, this is a single term. And minus 7, this is again a single term. So, they come under monomial. Now, here you see this example, 2x minus 3y. This contains two terms, 2x and minus 3y. So, they contain two terms. So, they come under binomials. You can even see this example, they contain two terms. So, they come under binomials. Let us see this. A plus B plus C. This contains three terms. They are three different terms. Okay. So, they come under trinomials. Now, let us see this. A square minus 3A square B plus 2AB minus B cube. There are four terms. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, four terms means more than three terms. So, when an expression has more than three terms, it comes under polynomials. Okay, this much is very clear. Now, we will see few examples to classify algebraic expressions as monomials, binomials, trinomials, and polynomials. Now, can you see these expressions? Here, we need to classify these expressions according to the number of terms they carry. Okay, so let us first see this term. So, this contains a single term. So, this will come under monomial. So, we will write this down under monomial. Now, look at this term. This contains two terms. Okay? So, expressions with two terms are binomials. So, we will write this down under binomial. Okay, next, look at this expression. This contains a single term. So, it will come under monomial. Now, let us see this expression. How many terms does this contain? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, more than three terms, and more than three terms comes under polynomials. So, this expression will come under polynomial. Okay, we'll see this expression. There are three terms. 1, 2, 3. So, three terms comes under trinomial. So, 5x square minus 11. Now again, this term contains, this expression contains two terms. So, it will come under binomial. So, 5m minus 3. Okay. This expression contains how many terms? 1, 2, 3. So, 3 terms. So, it will come under trinomial. Let us see this term, this expression. How many terms does this expression contain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So more than 3 terms, so it will come under polynomials. Now, this classification is just to make you aware of the number of terms an expression contains and how to put them in correct columns and how to classify them as monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomial. I hope this basic concept of algebraic expression is clear to you all. Still, if you have any queries related to this topic, then you can put your queries in the comment box. And if you want us to make more videos on algebraic expression and their operations, then do let us know in the comment box. Do like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel Connecting with Numbers. And do not forget to press the bell icon for updates on new videos. Bye-bye, take care. We will be back with another video soon.